Okay guys, we're doing some modifications on a 2013 Dodge Ram Hemi 5.7 1500 two-wheel drive. One of the modifications is a 180 degree thermostat. Wanted to go over, I was really fighting this truck getting air out of the system. And whenever I'd go out and make a run, when I was on wide open throttle, the temperature would begin to climb even with the 180 thermostat until I lifted. When I lifted, the temperature really began to spike to around 202, 205. And I didn't like that. I mean, the whole idea of a 185 degree thermostat was to bring the motor temperatures down so that it would be more favorable for more timing and not have to have so much retard kicking in on it. So wanted to show you guys some of the challenges I had. One of the things that I had to do was I had to have a good size funnel, and it needs to fit inside the neck pretty snug. And this one does. It fits tight around the opening inside right here. It fits inside the opening tight before it bottoms out on the radiator. The water comes in and goes that way. So you don't want the funnel going all the way down and closing that off. Mine stops about right there. And then it allows the water to go in, and it's secure around the opening. So it's snug. It's gonna create a lock around the opening. What I ended up doing was I ended up flushing the system several times. My system was pretty dirty, and this right here is your friend, distilled water. I went through probably 16 to 18 gallons of distilled water flushing this thing out, but didn't want to use tap water. My tap water here is really hard and leaves a lot of deposits, so I didn't want that forming into the truck. The drain plug is down on the passenger side on my truck. It's a 10 millimeter Allen wrench. When I started this process, I noticed when I took the original Dodge thermostat out of here, the 205 thermostat, it was pretty nasty looking. It had a lot of like oily residue and et cetera on it. So the first thing I did was I went and modified the old thermostat. Actually, I had a 195 or 192 degree thermostat that I had gotten from Summit Racing. And I modified that to allow me to flush out the radiator. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So on the Dodge Hemi, the thermostat has a gasket around it that seals up the top hose and everything. So this was a 192 degree thermostat that I had bought from Summit before I started going down the Hemifever Tune path. What I did, I didn't want to have a thermostat in there while I was flushing it out with the Blue Devil. So I took this one, I chucked it up in the vise because I knew I wasn't going to use it anymore. And I cut with a hacksaw these two points so that I can end up with this. So after modifying this in the vise and cutting this off, this is the piece I wanted. So then what I did is I took the top radiator hose off and put this in to the water pump while I was running before I put the Blue Devil in. That way I knew I wasn't gonna, you know, get a bunch of trash to clog up the small opening in a thermostat. And by using that, it also sealed the thermostat housing. I didn't have to worry about that leaking because the rubber gasket was in place. Then I did my radiator flush using distilled water. Before I put the Blue Devil in, I installed this thermostat, which means I had to drain it. And when you drain the radiator, you know, I did not drain the block. I understand people are gonna be like, man, you should have drained the block, etc. I understand. But what I did is I drained the radiator, put distilled water in it, ran it, got it up to temperature, drove it down the road, came back home, drained the radiator, added another couple jugs of distilled water in it, ran it down the road, came back, drained the radiator. So that's two drains with distilled water, trying to get all the antifreeze flushed out of it. And then I added the Blue Devil radiator flush, topped it off with distilled water, and then I drove it for about 4 days. I probably put around 10 to 12 hours on the truck over a 4 day period, driving it with the Blue Devil in it. Then I came back home after the fourth day or so and drained the Blue Devil back out of the radiator. I did two more flushes with distilled water, trying to get as much of the Blue Devil radiator flush out. And then with just straight distilled water, I drove it. I'm in Charleston, it's hot. We're nowhere near freezing, you know, this time in May. So at that point, I was able to drive it safely with just distilled water in it after the Blue Devil radiator flush with the heater open and on. And then I was able to keep the temperature around 185 degrees at most. And now what's interesting is with this modified thermostat in it, the temperature never got above 185 degrees in the truck. And this is in Charleston heat. I was tempted to just leave this in, but then I figured, well, in the winter time, the truck is gonna have some problems getting up to operating temperature and things such as that. So that's when I did the modification on the 180 degree thermostat. The modifications included me drilling. I drilled three 1/8-inch holes in the thermostat, and then I used my drill bit and I drilled out the little brass burp valve that was in there. And the reason why I did this is I wanted to know when I was burping this motor that with the thermostat not open, I was going to be able to use my funnel method and get all the air as much as I could out before I cranked it. And then when I cranked it and the water pump kicks in, of course you need to add water. And with this method, there's not enough water getting past the thermostat to not allow the motor to heat up. You're not going to cool a motor with just four small 1/8-inch holes for sure, but it does allow some water to get burped and some air to get out of the system while you're doing this. And then at that point, after I felt like I was flushed all the Blue Devil out, then I drained everything again, flushed it twice, and then again installed the modified thermostat. This is a spare 180 thermostat that I've modified for a friend of mine who also has a Dodge Hemi truck. So I did the exact same thing, but now my motor has that my modified thermostat installed in it. And at this point, I've flushed it a couple more times with distilled water. And after some good flushing, I'm gonna drive it a couple days with straight distilled water and my modified thermostat. And then this will go in it. So my truck uses the Oats Mopar antifreeze. And I've got 3 brand new gallons of antifreeze. And probably tomorrow or a couple days from now, I will drain the radiator again and then fill it up only with antifreeze. Now, absolutely, there will be some distilled water left in it because I did not drain the block. But I'm comfortable if I can get, you know, 2 gallons of Mopar Oats antifreeze in it, it's going to mix with the distilled water. And then in a couple weeks, I could go through another drain cycle and just go back with more Mopar antifreeze. Okay, here's the drain plug we're talking about, guys. It has an O-ring seal, and it's a number 10 Allen. It's time for the final fill with the Mopar antifreeze. I've gone through 4 full flushes with distilled water since running the Blue Devil. I just drained the radiator and now I'm going to fill it up with antifreeze and burp it. Now, I haven't cranked it yet. Got the radiator filled. And remember, I got the 4 eighth inch holes in the thermostat. So they're burping by and water is coming past the thermostat into this upper radiator hose, into the radiator. And also remember that radiator, upper radiator hose end is lower than this neck. And I've got the funnel with the additional water in the funnel. You can see the air is continuing to burp. I'm gonna work the upper radiator hose some. And while I do that, you can see it continuing to push air out through the radiator. I try to do this as much as possible before I crank it. But when I crank it, and you'll see here in a second, it will pull this down. And I'll have to add more antifreeze because, you know, the water pump is going to begin to circulate and push the water in places that gravity is just going to struggle getting it there. But also remember, I've got the heater turned on all the way on the highest heat setting before I started this. The goal is to have the heater circuit open so that as you're pouring radiator antifreeze in, it's filling up the heater core as well. Now, once I crank it, the water pump will definitely begin to fill all that up. Let's crank it and come back here and see what this does. This should get sucked down. I've got more antifreeze in here to use, and I've got another unopened gallon of antifreeze ready to go. So let's crank it up, see what happens. The truck has been sitting about, I don't know, almost 2 hours. Got it all the way on hot. Got it, the fan on speed 1. Remember, the goal is not to have the fan going. I want the motor to heat up. So right now we're at 136 on the coolant temp. And it should have sucked some of the coolant down out of the funnel. Let's take a look. Let me see if I can do this one-handed. I'm going to fill it up a little bit higher than normal because I want it to be high up want to create a high point for the air to come. You can see it bubbling. While it's doing that, I'm going to work the radiator hose. This is what was in it. So I feel it's important to not start trying to mix this with the old fashioned green antifreeze. I wanted to stay consistent and start and not start mixing antifreeze. See, it's still burping. I'm not gonna video all this. This is gonna be about a 15 or 20 minute process of me letting it burp, working the upper radiator hose, varying the idle, doing everything I can to get the air pockets out. Now it's been running about 15 minutes. I'm going to stop up the funnel and transfer the antifreeze in the funnel to the overflow tank, put the cap on, drive it down the road, come back and redo this funnel method. Another key purchase I did was a new motor rad 16-pound cap. Okay, so we're gonna go for a drive around the block. You can see right now we're at 163. I got the heater all the way up, fan on one, and it is definitely hot. You know, people who talk about, hey, a 180 thermostat's not gonna let your heater get hot. Well, I can tell you, the heater gets freaking hot. This is a crew cab truck and it'll run you out this truck. But anyways, I want to leave the heat on all the way so that I'm circulating water through the heater core, make sure I'm getting rid of all the bubbles there. Again, this is the Hemifever Tune. So it utilizes third gear, even in normal driving, which I'm in third gear right now. Take you along with me for a ride. It should get up to 185 here pretty quickly. Yes, the windows are down, so I'm sorry about the wind noise. 176. So you got to understand, even though I drilled those four holes, small holes, that's mainly for air bleeds. The thermostat's still gonna work. It's not gonna open until the water is, you know, 180 or a little above. Outside temperature right now is 78 degrees, as you can see from the dash in the upper right-hand corner there, 78 degrees outside. Truck has 137,549 miles on it. This Hemi runs amazing. Doesn't leak any oil, doesn't burn any oil. Once again, I'm running Amsoil 5W30 in it. I went up to 30 weight just because of being over 75,000 miles. All right, we'll make a right turn here and I'm gonna get up to speed a little bit. Thank you. go back home to the driveway, put the funnel back on it, and let's burp it one more time. This heater is definitely hot. Got a lot of traffic here, but this stop and go will be good to burp it. I'm just trying to be a little careful. I'm not wanting to get a whole bunch of pressure built up on the system. This little short ride is going to have some pressure on it. Back on when I pull up in the driveway. Okay, literally just pulled back up in the driveway. Here's the temps. Now let's burp it again. Heater's still on. Windows are down. You can see where I'm just going to work the upper radiator hose. Just intentionally trying to get as much air out of it as I can while I know the thermostat is open. We're at 185 degrees still. So I know they're... I know the cap is open. Excuse me. I know the thermostat is open. I know the water is flowing fully. It's looking good. I'm going to continue to work the upper radiator hose some. That radiator hose is hot to the touch, so you don't have to hold on to it very long. Once again, if you get a wider view of this, you can see that the truck is leaning down to the driver's side. So the funnel with the water in it is definitely the highest point on the vehicle. My driveway has a heavy lean. So, you know, from my house, the driveway leans towards this privacy fence. And of course, that's so the water runs away from the house. And that's important. You want the neck where you're adding water in your funnel to be the highest point in the system, because air will find its way to the highest point in the system to bubble out. So I got the truck leaning that way. So all air will eventually work its way to right here. Now, I could have done this in probably a couple hours in my driveway with just doing all the flushes and everything without driving it for days like I've done. But this is pretty critical to me to get all the air out and make sure this thing is cooling properly and running good. Temperature. We're staying at 185. like I showed you a few seconds ago, when I'm satisfied, I will transfer what's in here into the overflow tank. Just remove this out your way. Get your funnel down in there. So I'm not wasting that, right? If you may be wondering what the heck was that I used, it was this. I have a garden spade. Fits down in the funnel very well. Closes the funnel off so I can transfer it. Hey, it works. I think I'm about there. Well guys, this is not my normal drag racing suspension video, but the Dodge Ram Hemis have a huge following, and I've been pretty active on a lot of these forums, and I'm very appreciative of the information there. So I wanted to return some content back to these forums. Regardless of the content, I'm always trying to do three things. I'm trying to go fast, I'm trying to go straight, and I'm trying to be safe.